To strike a blow. Now, this all started Friday when Clinton called half of Donald Trump's supporters a basket of deplorables, a golden line for an attack ad. Trump pounced on that. Take a look.
Speaking to wealthy donors, Hillary Clinton called tens of millions of Americans deplorable.
You could put half of Trump's supporters into what I call the basket of deplorables. The racist, sexist, homophobic, xenophobic, Islamophobic, you name it.
People like you, you, and you, deplorable. You know what? Deplorable? Hillary Clinton viciously demonizing hardworking people like you.
Should point out her campaign, and she came out the next day, said she regretted saying half. Hillary Clinton is firing back with an ad that features something Mr. Trump said just yesterday on the campaign trail and using it against him. Take a look.
You can't leave such a low opinion for its citizens.
How stupid are the people of the country?
We're building a wall. He's a Mexican.
You got to see this guy. Oh, I don't know what I said. I don't remember.
You're living in poverty. Your schools are no good. You have no jobs. What the hell do you have to lose?
With me again, CNN Chief Political Analyst Gloria Borger. Joining us, CNN Senior Political Commentator, former Obama Senior Advisor David Axelrod. He also hosts the Axe-Files podcast, which I have been on, happily. And CNN Political Analyst and USA Today columnist Kirsten Powers. David, is this wise, you think, for the Clinton campaign to kind of go continue this line?
Well, the last thing they want is for Donald Trump to somehow, after the last year, seize the high ground as they turn the corner. One of the reasons that he's trailing among college-educated, particularly women, is because of the tenor of his campaign. And they've made a lot of progress with this, Hillary Clinton. She's leading among college-educated whites. Mitt Romney carried them by 14%. So they can't let this turn because she made this mistake on Friday. And so they thought this, they want to seize the high ground back and not allow Donald Trump somehow to become the sort of arbiter of civility.
It's interesting, Gloria, that Donald Trump is saying, you know, he's demanding an apology from Hillary Clinton, which is something he has never apologized.
Yeah, Donald Trump has said he regretted certain things.
Right, but never said,
but he never said what it was. So he didn't apologize to the Khan family, for example. To a degree, because he has name-called his opponents, et cetera, et cetera. So, you know, I don't blame Hillary Clinton for trying to sort of...
Pence also said today that he didn't want to call
David Duke.
David Duke.
Deplorable,
because that would be uncivil.
Right.
I'm not sure calling Dave a white supremacist deplorable is uncivil.
Right.
Kirsten, we're in this sort of interesting time period. I mean, after Labor Day, before the debates, it is possible for controversial things to pop up in the next week or two. But once the debates start, things could totally change, and this could all feel like a lifetime ago.
Yeah, well, I'm sure that that's true, but I think right now she's trying to get back to where she was after the convention, which, if we think back on it, was a much more aspirational, positive message than I think what we're having right now. And the problem with Donald Trump is, you know, as the saying goes, if you get down, you know, don't get down in the mud with pigs because you just get dirty and the pig likes it. She has to be careful about doing that. She doesn't want to get into these back and forth with him. Even this deplorable comment is kind of, you know, the type of comment, frankly, that a Trump would normally make. And so we saw the way he kind of dragged people down during the primary. We saw what he did with, for example, Marco Rubio, who really was this very aspirational, positive person who by the end sort of lost it and was saying all sorts of things that he ultimately said had embarrassed his daughters. And so I think it would be good for her to get back to that message that Michelle Obama said, you know, when they go low, we go high.
But this was her own creation, obviously, because of her deplorable comment, which gave him an opportunity, and she had to then respond. I agree with you, however, that in a perfect world, she should be giving people a reason to vote for her and not to vote against Donald Trump. But she's not living in a perfect world these last few days, and that's her problem.
Yeah. The problem is that I just feel that if you get into like a war with Donald Trump of who's going to be, you know, hitting harder, yeah. I just don't know that that's her strength. You know, I think that she has a good aspirational message. She has a lot going for her that's positive that would be better. Yes, she has to excite the base, I guess, with pointing out how awful Donald Trump is. But ultimately, she's got to give people a reason to vote for her.
David, when you saw President Obama out on the trail today, I mean, you know him probably, you know, better than anybody. What'd you see? What did you see in him, and how effective?
I saw a guy who was having a pretty good time, for one thing. I think he has been really eager to get out there. And he wants Hillary Clinton to win. I think he's genuinely offended by Donald Trump, and he expressed that in full today. And I think you're going to see a lot of that in October. The notion of an aspirational campaign is laudable. But someone's going to have to bring the attack. And she's got a lot of surrogates, and the president being chief among them, who can really make the case for her and against Donald Trump. And I think you're going to see it again and again.
Yeah. I want to thank everybody. Just ahead, another first in a presidential election that's defied expectations. Donald Trump's going to share the results of his recent physical on the Dr. Oz show on Thursday. Dr. Oz says he's not going to ask any questions that Trump doesn't want to answer. I'll talk to medical ethicist Art Kaplan about it.